So, welcome on this YouTube channel. This channel is very useful to all candidates who are preparing themselves for any nursing competitive exam such as state government exam, ASIS exam, AIIMS exam, army nursing exam, defense nursing exam, etc. And this channel is also being useful to all candidates who are trying to crack various entrance exam such as AIIMS, IGNOU, NIMHANS, etc. If you want to crack any nursing examination, then subscribe my YouTube channel, Rahul Makwanaik Nurse. So guys, today we will discuss about the various most important topic or question that openly ask in any nursing competitive examination. So I am welcoming all of you. Good morning, dear friends. You are most welcome on my YouTube channel named Rahul Makwanaik Nurse. This channel is being very helpful to all candidates who are preparing themselves for various nursing competitive examination such as state government nursing examination, GSSB nursing examination, departmental nursing examination, railway nursing examination, defense nursing examination and ESIS nursing examination. If you are watching my this channel, it means you are preparing yourself for any nursing competitive examination. My humble request to all of you, when you are watching video on my YouTube channel, it's advisable to keep a pen and notebook with you. That's why you can note down important point and various example in your notebook. If you are new on this channel, so I kindly requesting all of you for subscribe my YouTube channel and press the bell icon so you can receive latest notification of recently uploaded video lecture on this channel. So guys, in the last nursing video lecture 4, we have been discussed on the following topic, which are blood compatibility, CPR, pyrexia, thermodynamics, and last one is oxygen related terminology. So guys, in the previous lecture we have been learned various important topic such as a blood compatibility, in which we have to learn about the various kind of blood group and the person is which group person is known as the universal blood donor and the person with which blood group is known as the universal recipient. So this is the most two important MCQ that are openly asked in any nursing competitive examination. Then we will discuss about the CPR. So what is the meaning of CPR and what is the CP ratio to giving CPR in emergency situation. So in this condition we have two condition. If you are only one person, that which ratio you should follow. If you are two person, then which CPR ratio you should follow. This all we learn in this topic. And pyrexia, what is the meaning of pyrexia and classification of pyrexia. So we have discussed about the various kind of pyrexia that may be classified on the degree range of fever. And then we will discuss about the thermodynamics, what is the meaning of thermodynamics and various most important terminology of thermodynamics. That will be that may be conduction, convection, radiation and evaporation. So we have discussed about the what is the meaning of conduction, what is the meaning of convection, what is the meaning of radiation and what is the meaning of evaporation. So this all terminology, and we have also learned about the thermogenesis and thermolysis. The process of producing heat is known as the thermogenesis, and the process of decreasing and lowering the heat or reducing the heat is known as the thermolysis. So this all are the important terminology that are openly asked in the any nursing competitive examination. And last we have discussed about the oxygen related terminology, in which we have to learn about the hypoxemia, hypoxia. So this all are important topic for any nursing competitive examination. So in this nursing video lecture 5, we will discuss on the following topic. Our topic is of this video is breathing pattern and problems. So guys, this is one of the most important topic for the upcoming nursing examination. So we have to learn about the various kind of breathing pattern and problem in this video lecture. So are you ready? Can we start? Let's start the video lecture. So normal breathing pattern. So guys, in this figure there is two process. The taking air into the human body is known as the breath or inspiration. When the exhaling the heat exhaling the air from the human body or exiting the air from the human body is known as the exhalation. So guys, or is known as the expiration. So guys, this image is simply show the changing of air. If air is taking into the human body is known as the breath or inspiration. Whenever the removing air from human body or exiting the air from human body is known as the exhalation or expiration. So guys, what is the meaning of respiration? So simple meaning of respiration is inspiration and expiration, the process of taking air into the human body and the process of remove air or exhaling the air or exiting the air is known as the expiration. So respiration means inspiration plus expiration. The process of inspiration and the process of expiration is known as the respiration. Taking air from environment into the human body is known as the inspiration. Whenever the exhaling air into the environment from the human body is known as the expiration. So I hope this is the basic funda of breathing or simple funda of respiration now clear in your mind. So we have to moving from our main topic, abnormal breathing pattern. So guys, in this figure we have discussed about the normal breathing pattern. So taking air from environment to into the human body is known as the inspiration. Whenever the exhaling air into the environment is known as the expiration. The process of inspiration plus process of expiration is known as the respiration. So guys, this is a normal breathing pattern that are shown in this figure. So now we will discuss about the our main point or main topic that is abnormal breathing pattern. So guys, the abnormal breathing pattern may be classified into various kind, and that's all kinds are very important for any nursing competitive examination. So remember this old terminology, because this terminology will be asked in any nursing exam. So in first, the terminology is eupnea. Eupnea. So what is the meaning of eupnea? The normal breathing pattern is known as the eupnea. So in examination, the question will be asked such as a normal breathing pattern is known as the blank. Then our answer will be eupnea. Eupnea means, so our answer is normal breathing pattern. So eupnea means normal breathing pattern. So guys, remember this terminology, because this is one of the most important terminology in the respiratory system. The second terminology is dyspnea. What is the meaning of dyspnea, guys? The difficulty in breathing is known as the dyspnea. So exam will be asked any exam such as a difficulty in breathing is known as blanks. Then our answer will be dyspnea. The dyspnea and second equation is such as dyspnea means blank. Then our answer will be difficulty in breathing. So I hope now these two terminology are clear in your mind. So we have to learn about the third terminology, proximal nocturnal dyspnea. So guys, dyspnea is now clear in our mind. The simple meaning of dyspnea is difficulty into breathing. But here two words, proximal nocturnal. So attack of severe shortness of breath that wake the patient from the sleep is known as the proximal nocturnal dyspnea. So guys, nocturnal means during the sleep in the night. So proximal nocturnal dyspnea is attack of severe shortness of breath that wake present from the sleep is known as the proximal nocturnal dyspnea. So exam question will be asked in examination is such as attack of severe shortness of breath that wake person from sleep is known as the proximal nocturnal dyspnea. The second question in exam will be asked such as proximal nocturnal dyspnea means, so our right answer is attack of severe shortness of breath that wake person from the sleep. So I hope now this terminology will be clear in your mind. So now we will discuss about the next terminology, that orthopnea. So guys, remember this terminology because this is one of the most important terminology that oftenly asked in any nursing competitive examination. The terminology is orthopnea. So guys, what is the meaning of orthopnea? Unable to take breath comfortably into supine or lying position is known as the orthopnea. So guys, remember terminology from the orthopnea. So you have to thus remember orthopnea means ortho means you have to just remember supine or lying position. So what is the meaning of orthopnea? The meaning of orthopnea is unable to take breath comfortably into supine position. In this condition, patient is unable to taking the respiration or inspiration into supine or lying position is known as the orthopnea. So guys, remember this terminology because this is one of the most important terminology. Then question will be asked in exam such as unable to take breath comfortably into the supine or lying position is known as, then our answer will be orthopnea. Second question will be asked in exam such as orthopnea means, then our answer will be unable to take breath comfortably into the supine or lying position. So I hope this all terminology are now clear in your mind. Then we will discuss about the hyperemnea. So our terminology is hyperemnea. So what is the meaning of hyperemnea? The increased volume with or without increase the rate of respiration. Increase volume with or without increase the rate of respiration is known as the hyperemnea. So guys, in the hyperemnea, the volume will be increased, but sometime the rate of respiration does not change. In some condition, the rate of respiration will be changed. So guys, you have to just remember hyperemnea means increase volume with or without increase the rate of respiration. So exam will be question will be asked in exam such as increase volume with or without increase the rate of respiration is known as, then our answer will be hypnea. Second question will be asked in examination such as hyperemnea means or hyperemnea referred to, then blank, then our answer will be increase volume with or without increase the rate of respiration. So I hope this old terminology is now clear in your mind. So next we will discuss about the apnea. So what is the meaning of apnea? The absence of breath is known as the apnea. So guys, remember this is terminology because this is one of the second most important terminology from the abnormal respiratory pattern that oftenly asked in any nursing competitive examination. So means apnea means absence of breath. The question will be asked in exam such as or like as the absence of breath is known as blank, then our answer will be apnea. Second question asked into examination such as apnea means, then our answer will be absence of breath. So guys, now I hope this terminology is clear in your mind. Then we will discuss about the hyperventilation. So what is the meaning of hyperventilation? Overventilation above that needed for the body's CO2 elimination. Overventilation above that needed for the body's CO2 elimination is known as the hyperventilation. So guys, this is one of the most important terminology. that will be asked in exams such as overventilation above the needed for the body's CO2 elimination is known as the hyperventilation. Next, we will discuss about the hypoventilation. So guys, overventilation above that needed for the body's CO2 elimination is known as the hyperventilation. Whenever the underventilation below that needed for the body's CO2 elimination is known as the hypoventilation. So never being confused between two this terminology. Overventilation is known as the hyperventilation and underventilation is known as the hypoventilation, but in which in the body's CO2 elimination process. So I hope now these two terminology is clear in your mind. The last terminology is Kussmaul's respiration. So guys, remember this terminology because this is one of the most important terminology that oftenly asked in any nursing competitive examination, either it may be RBI examination, state government examination, ESIS examination, or any competitive departmental examination. So Kussmaul respiration. So what is the meaning of Kussmaul respiration? So Kussmaul respiration defined to deep singing respiration pattern at a normal or slow rate. Deep sighing respiration pattern at normal or slow rate is known as the Kussmaul respiration. So we have to remember deep sighing respiratory pattern. So guys, remember this terminology. The question in the exam will be asked such as a deep sighing respiratory pattern at a normal or slow rate is known as the, then our answer is Kussmaul respiration. Kussmaul respiration refer to blank, then our answer will be deep sighing respiratory pattern at a normal or slow rate is known as the Kussmaul respiration. And the last terminology, Biot's respiration. So what is meaning of Biot's respiration? So Biot's respiration refer to regular deep respiration interspread with the period of apnea is known as the Biot's respiration. So we have to remember the regular deep respiration interspread with period of apnea is known as the Biot's respiration. So guys, this is the last terminology. So we will revise the terminology. So normal breathing pattern is taking air from environment into the human body is known as the inspiration. Whenever the exhaling air into the environment from the human body is known as the expiration. So process of inspiration and expiration is known as the respiration. So this is the normal breathing pattern. Then we have to discuss about the normal abnormal breathing pattern. Among them, apnea. The normal breathing pattern is known as the apnea. Difficulty in breathing is known as the dyspnea. The third terminology, attack of severe shortness of breath that wake patient from sleep is known as the proximal nocturnal dyspnea. Unable to take breath comfortably into supine or lying position is known as the orthopnea. Increased volume with or without increase the rate of respiration is known as the hyperemia. Absence of breath is known as the apnea. Overventilation above that needed for the body's CO2 elimination is known as the hyperventilation. Whenever the underventilation below that needed for the body's CO2 elimination is known as the hypoventilation. Deep sighing respiratory pattern at a normal or slow rate is known as the Kussmaul respiration. And the last terminology we have discussed, it was Biot's respiration. The regular deep respiratory interspread with the period of apnea. So you have to remember this keywords, period of apnea. So regular deep respiration interspread with the period of apnea is known as the Biot's respiration. So I hope abnormal breathing pattern terminology is clear in your mind. So in this figure, the old terminology we have discussed is shown in this figure. Apnea means normal breathing rate and pattern. Tachypnea means increased respiratory rate. Bradypnea means decrease the respiratory rate. The process of increasing respiratory rate is known as the tachypnea. The respiratory rate is decreased is known as the bradypnea. Absence of breathing is known as the apnea. Increased depth and rate of breathing is known as the hyperapnea. Sign stroke gradually increase in the decrease the respiration with the period of apnea is known as the sign stroke. Biot's respiration is abnormal breathing pattern with group or cluster of rapid respiratory of equal depth regular apnea period. So, and last one is Kussmaul's tachypnea with hyperapnea is known as the Kussmaul's respiration. So guys, thank you all of you. If you are new on this my YouTube channel, then subscribe my YouTube channel and press the bell icon for the latest video notification. If this video is being useful to you, then I requesting you to like this video and share this video to maximum with your group, and never forget to subscribe this channel for the latest upcoming video lecture of nursing. So till now, best of luck and best reading, and thank you all of you guys.